Okay, my dear students, today we will do chapter 1 of class 6, and in chapter 1, when we started online classes, we preferred to start from chapter 2, which is bearing a story, but now it has come the turn of chapter 1. And the chapter's title is Only God Can Make a Tree. The poet, who is anonymous here, means the poet has preferred not to give his name, mention his name, for writing this poem. There are many poets and writers who prefers to be anonymous, not willing to take the credit of writing stories and poems. Similarly, but this beautiful poem has been written by a very generous heart. The poem starts like that: I think that I shall never see a poem so lovely as a tree. The poet says that he will not see in his lifetime a poem so lovely like a tree. Means the poet compares a tree with that of a poem, and he says that for him a tree is also a poem, and none of the poem which is written by a poet is more beautiful than the trees. Means for the poet, the trees are the best poetry. The trees are the best poems, and its other activities are poetry. A tree whose hungry mouth is pressed against the earth's sweet flowing breast. As we compare the earth with mother, the poet also accepts the same, and he says that as our mothers do feed us with her breast, this earth is also feeding the trees with her breast, and these trees are growing like anything. A tree that looks at God all day and lifts her leafy arms to pray. For the poet, the movement of the branches of the tree appears that these trees are looking towards God, and they are lifting their hands in order to pray the God. Means these trees are very blessed and are thankful to God that God has provided the trees the opportunity to grow and prosper. A tree that may in summer wear a nest of robins are here. How the trees are here, the trees are motivated and inspired with the generosity of earth, that as earth is very generously feeding the trees, so it should also do something good for others. In order to do that good, the trees are providing the spaces for making nest for the robins and other birds. Upon whose bosom a snow has lain. Yes, in the bosoms of the trees, as they are standing there in the mountain area, hill areas where the snow is falling, they bear it on their branches. Who intimately lives with rain, and they not only bear the burden of the snows, they do also intimately lives with the rain, means they have developed a sense of coexistence to live with rain, which is also a part of our nature. How beautifully this poet has explained the sense of coexistence through this tree, that this tree is not only thankful to God and earth for bestowing generously the facility useful for the tree's life, but through the tree the poet has also successfully explained that as these trees are providing spaces for birds for making their nests, as well as they do bear the burden of the snow, as well as they have learned to live happily with other parts of things which has been made by nature, and that is rain. Poems are made by fools like me, but only God can make a tree. Yes, this the brilliant comment this poet has made here. He tells that even a fool can make a poem, but it is God only who can make a tree. So the poem is a small one, but it has been sketched brilliantly by that anonymous poet. Through this poem, he not only explains that we should be thankful to God what He has given to us very generously, but he gives the message that we should try to develop a sense of coexistence, and we should believe in the concept live and let live, jiyo or jine do. Thank you very much.